Subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
A commonly asked question these days is, when will this all end? And by this all, the COVID-19 pandemic, of course. There is a mathematical answer to this question, and that is when the effective reproduction number, or R, of a disease falls below 1. It is at this point that the disease is no longer considered to be an epidemic and thus no longer a threat. There is mathematics behind how scientists are tracking the spread of the disease and establishing at what stage of epidemic COVID-19 is at currently. The way this is done is through the basic reproduction number, a number commonly referred to as R0. R0 is a measure of how many people one infected person can in turn infect given a fully susceptible population. If R0 is greater than 1, a person can infect more than one other person on average, and thus the disease spreads exponentially. If it's lower than 1, a person infects less than one person on an average, and there is no risk of a pandemic. Currently, R0 for COVID-19 is somewhere between 1 and 2. R0 is indicated by R with a subscript of 0 because it shows how many people the zeroth case, or the very first person who was ever infected, infected others. It is important because R0 varies with time, geography, and human behavior. Now, this far along into the pandemic, R0 is replaced with the effective reproduction number, which is indicated by RE, R with a subscript of small e, or simply R. The effective reproduction number is the number of people in a population who can be infected by any individual at any specific point in time. It changes with time, and it changes as the population becomes increasingly immunized, either through exposure to infection or through vaccination. It also changes as infected people die, and of course, as people start practicing physical distancing measures. At this point, R0, R, RE are all used interchangeably. For convenience, we're going to continue using R0 here because it's the term that most people are familiar with today. R0 is affected by multiple factors. One is the density of population. An infection originating in Wuhan, in densely populated China, will spread much faster than one originating in, say, a sparsely populated region of the Sahara Desert. It also depends on the infectiousness of the virus. The SARS-CoV-2 virus is fairly infectious. While it's more infectious than the previous SARS virus, it is much less transmissible than something like measles, for example. It also depends on the deadliness of the virus. Once again, the previous SARS virus was quite deadly. Most diseases that are very deadly and kill fast don't spread fast, as people become too sick to step out and infect others. For diseases that are more deadly, people also survive less, so naturally the disease has lower chances of spreading. R0 also depends on human behavior. As humans start practicing physical distancing and adopting personal hygiene measures, the number will naturally start to fall. R0 is estimated from data collected in the field and entered into mathematical epidemiological models. The estimated value depends both on the quality of data that is being input as well as the model itself that is working on the data. Mathematical modeling is performed in multiple countries around the world, with famous models from the UK and US adopted everywhere during the early days of the pandemic. But as the disease has progressed and human behavior changes from country to country, each country or region ends up having their own mathematical model, which gives out a more accurate number and a better understanding of how the disease is spreading in that community. Modeling in India is done by a number of institutes, including IIT Madras, IIT Guwahati, IMSC, ICER Kolkata, and several others. Understanding the dynamics of an infectious disease in its early stages for R0, for the patient zero, is challenging because of a number of factors such as lack of data, lack of awareness, shortage of reagents, which are chemicals that are used for testing and other processes, and of course, very sudden onset of physical distancing measures. The first estimation of R0 for Wuhan was 2.2, and this was estimated towards the end of January from under 500 confirmed cases. A month later, it was estimated to be slightly higher at 2.68, and then later it was estimated to be as high as 5.7. The number is no longer considered to be accurate. Now the amount of data available is much higher and much localized, enabling researchers to make more accurate estimates of the number. In India, the number has constantly hovered between 1.1 and 1.7 so far. Calculating the effective reproductive number at any given point of time, what we're currently referring to as R0, depends on three factors. The probability of infection when a susceptible person comes in contact with an infected individual, the average rate of contact between susceptible and infected individuals, and the duration during which an individual spreads the infection. The epidemiological models compute how fast the virus spreads between generations of infected people. The very first person who contracted the virus is patient zero for the pandemic and serves as the index case, although several countries refer to index case as the first diagnosed patient. Every individual that patient zero directly gives the virus to becomes a part of the first generation, and every individual they infect in turn become a part of the second generation, and so on. As the infectious disease spreads out of control exponentially, of course, it becomes increasingly difficult to model considering all of the physical distancing measures and other hygiene measures that we adopt, which induce a bias in data. So R0 for a disease is simply the number of patients the index case infected, the patient zero infected, when there were no countermeasures in place. The rate of spread in the first generation of the infection is called R1, and then the next R2, and so on. Any revisions in the R0 estimate threatens to have massive impact on the authorities' response to a disease. According to researchers who conducted the Wuhan study, when R0 is around 2.2, only about 55% of the population needs to be immune through either vaccine or prior infection for the disease to stop spreading. At an R0 of 5.7, the threshold rises drastically to 82%, a number that puts extreme pressure on public health systems to come up with vaccinations and drugs at a much faster rate. This concept of a threshold of a population getting infected so that the disease becomes less deadly is called herd immunity. When enough people in a community achieve immunity, the disease stops being an epidemic. It was a strategy that the UK flirted with for a little bit before realizing that if the disease just washes over its citizens unmitigated, a large portion of the population would die. Herd immunity is a concept that is associated with vaccinations and cannot be achieved naturally without thousands to even millions of preventable deaths. This is Sandhya Ramesh from Bengaluru for The Print.